If you're interested in learning how to tune your Subaru using open source tuning software such as EcuFlash and RomRaider, then our EcuFlash worked example in our Practical Reflash Tuning course is going to be perfect for you. Open source tuning software offers a very powerful and cost-effective way of tuning your car. However, traditionally it's been hard finding solid information on how to use it and what you need to do in order to optimize your tune. That's where this worked example comes in. In particular, it'll show you how to apply the HPA 6-step reflashing process on the EcuFlash platform. You'll learn how to correctly rescale your mass airflow sensor and how to adjust the load compensation tables inside of the Subaru ECU. You'll learn how to adjust the breakpoints in your fuel and ignition tables, as well as the various limiters to cope with higher load than stock, and how to dial in your fueling perfectly. You'll also learn how the Subaru ECU controls ignition timing and how the base ignition tables, advanced tables and the ignition advanced multiplier work together to determine the final ignition timing the engine receives. You'll then see how to modify these tables to gain better control of your final ignition timing and provide a smoother and more consistent power delivery. You'll learn how the Subaru ECU detects knock and what parameters you should be logging to know when this is happening, and how to pinpoint exactly where your tables need to be modified in order to correct it. You'll also learn how the Subaru ECU controls boost and how to dial in the various tables to suit your desired boost targets. When it comes to reflashing a factory ECU, logging is critical since you usually can't make live tuning changes. You'll see how to use RomRaider to log your Subaru ECU, and you'll learn which parameters are critical to your specific tuning task. You'll also see how to use Mega Log Viewer to analyse your log files and quickly dial in each aspect of your tune. Lastly, you'll see how to confirm your tune out on the road or racetrack to make sure that everything we saw on the dyno remains accurate under real-world conditions. While we've presented this worked example using our version 11 Subaru STI, this worked example is going to be applicable to the wider range of Subaru vehicles since the ECU control strategies are very similar across the range. Click the link for more information.